Chief Architect has given us many convenient tools for creating landscape plans. You can find all of the landscaping tools here under the Terrain drop-down menu. Like the Terrain feature, Garden Bed, Water feature, Stepping Stones, Terrain Wall, and Curb, as well as the Sidewalks and Road tools. You can have quicker access to these tools by changing the toolbar configuration. These five buttons will change all of the tools here in the main toolbar. They are toolbar configurations. This one is the Terrain toolbar configuration. Now you will see all of the same tools as you do in the drop-down menu with easier access. You will notice here that I have created a slope terrain to practice on. First, let's take a look at the Terrain feature parent tool. In the child tools here on the left, you have the rectangle feature, spline feature, and the kidney shape feature. I'll start here by using the rectangle feature tool. Click and drag a rectangle here in the camera view. You can see that the terrain feature follows the slope of the terrain. This is true for all of the terrain features that we will work with in this video. You can draw your terrain feature either in camera view or in the floor plan view. Once you have placed a terrain feature, you can edit it. Select the feature and use the edit handles on the edges or on the corners to resize or reshape it. You can also use the temporary dimensions that are displayed when you select one of the edges. You can also edit the feature by selecting it and then use the Open Object tool in the Edit toolbar at the bottom of your screen to open the Terrain Feature Specification dialog. In this dialog, you can change the height or thickness of the feature. I'll change this one to sink it into the terrain by typing in a negative 12 inches. You can also change the material by going to the Materials tab and then click here on the feature, then click on Select Material here. That will open the library browser. Then I'll type in a search for dirt. Select this and click OK. The Garden Bed tools work exactly like the terrain features. However, they have a handy feature built in. I'll double-click here on the garden bed. In the specification dialog, you will find the Distribute Plants panel. The garden bed is the only one of the terrain features that has this option. I can use this to distribute plants across the entire garden bed. I'll click on Select, which will take me into the library browser, where I can select a plant to spread over the whole bed. Here, I'll type in the name of the plant I want to use, and then click OK. This is a fruit tree, so I'll type in 120 inches for the distance apart. You can set the offset, the angle, and the scaling if you want random sizes for your plants. When you make a change, you will see the results here in the preview pane. When I click OK, you can see now that I have an orchard. When you delete the garden bed, the plants will disappear as well. Another terrain feature tool is the water features tools. The round pond, the kidney-shaped pond, and the stream. This might be easier to do in the floor plan view. As you can see, the stream will maintain a constant width as I click and drag a line. But let's say I want to widen it out in one area. I'll select it in the floor plan view and click on Convert to Polyline Object. Then I'll select a couple of the edge edit handles and move it out to widen this area. Use the Convert to Spline tool in the Edit toolbar, and then use the Breakpoint Edit handles to move the curves. Now, let's double-click on it here and change the height to a negative 18, again to drop it down in the terrain. The next thing we want to do is change the material of the stream. I'll go to the Material panel and select the Terrain Path, then click on Select Material to open the library browser. Go into Landscaping and to Decorative Rock and Gravel and select the River Rock and click OK. Now I want to add some water to the stream. So I'll select the stream and go to Edit and copy paste in place. Then open that object Change the height to +3 so that it sits above the rocks. Then, go to the materials and select a water material. As you can see now, the stream has carved out a dropped stream in the terrain, but still maintains the terrain slope as well. Let's also take a look at the fence tools. Here in the Child Tools panel, you have the straight fence and the curved fence. Click on one and then click and drag a line to create the fence where you want it. The fence behaves the same as a wall, but it will follow the terrain slope, like the terrain features do. You can edit the fence default settings if you go to Default Settings, to Wall, and then scroll down to find the fence settings. The terrain wall works the same way. Click on the tool and then click and drag a line to create a wall. This wall will also follow the slope of the terrain. If you double-click on the wall that we created to open the specification dialog, you can change the height and width and change the materials. Roads and driveways and sidewalks work the same way. You can create a straight road, a splined road, or create a shaped road by using the polyline road tool. If I double-click on this road, you will see that it has the option to add curbs and change the height and width or materials. The sidewalk tool also follows the terrain. If you want to add a curb, you can use the curb tool in the terrain wall and curb tools. With the sidewalks, roads, and driveways, you can raise or lower them above or below the terrain itself, but still maintain the slope of the terrain. The stepping stone tools are very simple. Select the square or round stepping stones and then click to place them individually. If you click and drag, you can change the shape a bit, or you can reshape them by selecting them and then use the edit handles to change the shape. You can also select them and use the Open Object tool to open the specification dialog, where again you can change the height, the thickness, and the material. If I create a large stepping stone, you can see that like other terrain features, they will follow the slope of the terrain. Once you have finished the hardscape with the terrain features, you can then add plants and accessories to create the perfect landscape plan.